to our science demonstration this Sabbath, and it's called the silencing. And you're going to see what I mean as we move on. Now, in our slide demonstration on slide 2 is a list of materials needed for this demonstration. And Ashley's here with me to help with our little science demonstration. You need a radio. Or we're going to use an iPod or an iPhone today because we don't receive radio reception up in our little valley very well. So we're going to transmit it through the Wi-Fi. But you need a radio of some sort, a paper bag or a cardboard box, a plastic bag, a cloth bag, a glass bowl. It can be with a lid or without a lid. A metal pot with a metal lid. Aluminum foil. We're not going to use all those things this morning, but these are possibilities you can use. I even read of using a juice box that you open up and put your iPhone or whatever in it or your little radio and cover it back up and see if it works. All right, so these are possible materials. Slide number 3 is a picture of a radio with an antenna, and we might come back to this picture. Slide 4 is a paper box, a cardboard box. Slide 5 are those paper bags that we're going to use in our demonstration today. Slide 6 is a glass bowl. Slide 7 is a cloth bag. Slide 8 is a metal pan, which you would need a metal lid for. Now we're going to go to slide 9, and you can just look at that while I prepare over here. Now, what we have, what we're going to use today is an iPhone. Like I said, radios don't pick up signals very well. The music is coming from the iPhone through the routers to the speakers. It's the same as if you were using a radio, but we have to adapt here at the office. And so the music is coming from our iPhone through the router into our speakers. Now I'm going to turn it down just a little bit while I tell you why we're doing this. You see, God is speaking to our hearts. Speaking to our hearts and our minds every day, trying to draw us close to Him, trying to make His image created in our hearts and our minds. And He's speaking to us, just like a radio or the music. We hear that. But sometimes we don't want to hear what God has to say. And so we might try to cover it up. And so we're going to, put the radio perhaps in a closet. But it doesn't, it's still, if you have it turned on, you can still hear it in the closet. The wood doors, the closet framing and drywall, etc., don't block out the music. We could try putting it in a cardboard box. Let's wait till the music comes back on. And so I'm going to put this iPhone, or it would be your radio, in a cardboard box and cover it up. And see if that will drown out the sound. But it doesn't. You can still hear the music. And you can still hear God speaking to you, even though you might try to drown it out. Okay, so paper or cardboard doesn't work, so we'll get rid of that box. We're going to try a glass. See if glass will block out. So what we need to do, Ashley can help us. We're going to put our transmitter, which is the phone, and cover it up with glass and see if that will block out the sound. No, you can hear it just as well. And so there are things that you might do to try to silence the voice of God to your hearts and your minds. But God is persistent, and He still comes through. So let's try something else. Let's try a plastic bag. Oh, I have lots of helpers here. Okay, Ashley, put our transmitter into this bag and wrap it up and see if that will interrupt the radio waves. Oh, there's a hole in it. Okay, cover it up. Doesn't block it. So plastic doesn't work, glass doesn't work, paper doesn't work. Let's try a cloth bag in that black bag over there. We'll get rid of the plastic. And we have a cloth bag that we'll bring over here, Ashley, and we'll try to wrap that up in the cloth and see if that will drown out. Hold it up for a second. See if that will stop the music, but it doesn't. We try all kinds of things to silence the voice of God in our hearts and our minds, but God is persistent. What about if we could even try our bodies? Can you cover this up with your hands all the way and see if that will, and I'll use my hands too. Still there. We can't stop it. Okay, thank you, Ashley. Now, there's one thing we haven't tried in our list, and that's like a metal pan. If we put it in a metal pan, I don't have a metal pan, and covered it up with a metal lid, that might work. But in its place of the pan, we're going to wrap it in aluminum foil and see how that will affect the sound. So, Ashley, you go right ahead. Wrap, wrap, wrap. And wait, let's turn it up so we can make sure the sound, we can see what happens. It looks good to eat, doesn't it? Okay. Very good. Let's keep a wrapping. Something happened. Right in the middle of the song. It stopped it. It silenced it. Now let's open it up a little bit. See if we can get our music back. There it is. Metal silences the music that we're... Go ahead, let's see, Ashley. We're wrapping it several times because we do not have heavy-duty aluminum foil, so we're making our own heavy-duty. Oh, it's gone. What did you do, Ashley?
You blocked it all.
Did you push a button in there?
No.
Okay. Unwrap it just to show the people that the music is still there, but the metal has blocked it. There you go. Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Now we want to move. We can silence that now. Thank you, Ashley. I want to tell you what's happened in this particular demonstration. And we're going to go to slide 10 for the explanation. Radio signals are electromagnetic waves. They are an invisible form of light. How fast, Ashley, does light travel? Do you remember? It travels at 186,000 miles per second. And these light waves are like sound, they can be sound waves. We're talking about sound waves, but it's the same. It's invisible through, it goes through houses, through doors, through windows at 186,000 miles per second. Next slide. You can even cover the radio with your body and the signal will pass through you. So those electromagnetic waves not only pass through bricks and cement and whatever, they pass through human beings, and we tried to show that by covering it up with our hands. Next slide, slide 12. Metal, however, completely stops the waves. This is why a metallic car needs an external antenna in order to play music inside the car. And if we go back to slide 3, if we surrounded this radio, for example, with aluminum foil but left the antenna exposed, it would still get music. Do you know why?
The antenna
is sending the information into the radio. However, if we bent down the antenna in slide 3 so that it was close to the radio and wrapped the whole thing up with metal, it would block the electromagnetic waves coming into it. And so that's the principle of why at least the old-fashioned cars and maybe all the cars now, I don't know, had an antenna outside to bring the radio waves into the radio inside. Okay, we were at 12. Let's move to slide 13. A metal pot or aluminum foil has lots of free electrons which can move around inside the metal walls, and these electrons act like tiny antennae as an electromagnetic wave hits the metal surface. The wave's electric field pushes free electrons and causes them to accelerate, and they move in new directions, and therefore they're not focused in onto the radio. Next slide. Cardboard is an insulator, slide 14, and it doesn't have free electrons to be activated by these electromagnetic waves coming at it. Now, there are spiritual lessons that I want to draw from this little demonstration. And the first lesson is in slide 16. Covering the radio with your body is like trying to stop Satan's schemes on your own. The arrows of Satan can penetrate our own defenses and lead to failure. That's why we must be covered with the armor of God. And if we back up to slide 15, we have Ephesians 6:11, which says, "Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil." So we need God's armor to deflect the arrows and the darts and the problems Satan is trying to send our way. But there's something else, and that's what we talked about last week. We talked a little bit about the sin against the Holy Spirit, and I refer to that in slide 17, quoting Matthew 12:31, which says, "Wherefore, I say unto you, all manner of sin and blasphemy shall be forgiven unto men, but the blasphemy against the Holy Ghost shall not be forgiven unto men." Now, slide 18, we can reject the Holy Spirit as we discussed last week. Slide 19, we can put up our own shields against God's voice speaking to us, and those shields might be symbolized by the cardboard and the plastic and the cloth and the glass. All of that we might be trying to push God away with, whatever it is in our lives, but he still gets through. He still tries to speak to us. But finally, if we keep resisting and keep resisting his spirit, it will be as if metal has come between us and God, and his voice is no longer heard in our lives. And we don't want to get to that point. It's true, we've all tried to push, most likely all of us, I can't speak for all of us, have tried to do our own things, go our own ways, make our own decisions, and thus exclude God from our lives. But because we're all here wanting to learn more about him, I believe that all of us, even though we put up glass and cardboard and all the flimsy things trying to turn God away from us, he's still there and is still working with us. Next slide, slide 20. The longer we resist, however, the more dense our barrier becomes until it reaches the resistance of metal and no heavenly voice can penetrate the shell that we've created around us. This is like what happens when we sin against the Holy Spirit. So this demonstration really shows two different things. Using the armor of God to deflect and to quiet and silence that voice of Satan in our minds. But we can also silence the voice of God by our actions too. Okay, that ends our little demonstration, and we hope you come back next week and see what God has planned for us again. Thank you.